should find yourself more weary than usual. And I encourage you this morning to invite God's Holy Spirit to revitalize you from the inside out. Why not lay claim this morning and declare Jesus has come to give me life, and that life more abundantly. And he said, not Bishop, Jesus said, out of my belly, out of my heart, out of the experiences of my womb, out of me, inside of me shall flow what? Rivers of living water. The third thing I see here in Psalm 1:3, the true man or woman of God reproduces spiritual fruit. Another part of that verse is, he is like a tree planted by streams of water, what? That yields its fruit in its season. Underscoring there, yields its fruit. We're talking about what? Productivity. We look at stability, vitality, and what? Productivity. As true and trustworthy followers of Jesus, we're supposed to be, watch this, filled up, not fed up, with reproducing the life of faith Jesus gave us. I mean, isn't that what the Apostle James, the half-brother of Jesus, taught? Let me paraphrase James' conversation with the New Testament followers. So you say you have faith. How real is it? How genuine is your faith? You say you have faith. You profess that you have faith. So how is your faith? What are you doing with your faith? James said, faith without works is dead faith. So don't just tell me that you have living faith, abiding faith, power-packed faith, prophetic faith. Show me that you have power-packed, prophetic, living, abiding faith. Because faith without works is nothing more than dead faith. Folks, we're followers of Jesus are not supposed to be filled up, or supposed to be filled up and not fed up with reproducing the Christ-like character or Christ-like power, the faith of God. Isn't that what Jesus encourages us?
Yes.
Pastor, thank you so much for your timely prayer call this morning. It's on the first page of your bulletin. If you haven't read that quote yet, I would encourage you to take the bulletin home and memorize that quote this week. Dr. Henry Blackaby quoted something regarding prayer. Watch the big screen. Thank you again, Pastor. If you commit yourself to spend sustained time in prayer, watch this. God will work in your life as he did in Jesus and his disciples. The fervent prayer of the people at Pentecost didn't induce the Holy Spirit to come upon them. No, prayer brought them to where they were ready to participate in the mighty work God had already planned. Prayer is what prepares you and me to produce the life of Christ and the faith we have in Christ. See, the fruit that is mentioned here yields its fruit in its season is the same thing as mentioned in Galatians chapter 5. It's called fruit of the Spirit. The Apostle Paul taught you and me that we have to have, we should have, we need to have fruit of the Spirit, which is the Christ-like character. Galatians chapter 5, verse 22 and 23. What does it look like? But the fruit of the Spirit is love. It's joy. It's peace. It's patience. It's kindness. It's goodness. It's faithfulness. It's gentleness. It's self-control. Against us there is no law. It looks like Jesus. I remember in Mark's Gospel, very early in the Gospel, there was a particular story that always bothered me as a young Christian. You see Jesus coming up to a fig tree. The disciples are with him. And Jesus curses the fig tree. As a young believer, that bothered me. Because as the co-creator of all good things, I wondered why Jesus would curse something he created. I mean, he himself said it was good because he was in the beginning with God, right? He called it good, and in Mark's gospel, He curses it. Why did Jesus curse something he called good? You read that story, the Bible says, the disciples asked the question, why? Jesus said, because all that's growing on the tree is leaves. There are no figs on this fig tree. Oh, there's plenty of fig leaves, but there's no figs. In other words, there's no fruit on the tree. So he curses the tree. Let me remind you this morning, remind you that there is a holy inspector walking among us. A holy fruit inspector who is walking among you and me today. He's always expecting our lives for spiritual fruit or character of Christ. As a matter of fact, in John chapter 16, Jesus said that's one of the ministries of the holy inspector. John chapter 16, here we go. And when he has come, speaking of the Holy Ghost, he will convict the world of sin and of righteousness and of judgment of sin because they do not believe in me. Of righteousness because I go to my Father and you see me no more. Of judgment because the ruler of this world is judged. Jesus says, I still have many things to say to you, but cannot bear them. You cannot bear them now. However, when he, that is the Spirit of what? Truth has come, he will guide you into all I didn't hear you. All truth. For he will not speak on his own authority, but whatever he hears, he will speak. And he what? Will tell you things to come. Things that are true. Things that are trustworthy. Things that you can take to your grave.